Now we will create a railing for the stair opening inside. It takes quite a complex path, so instead of using library parts, we will create a profiled wall. Custom profiles allow us to create any kind of extruded geometry. You can also create profiled beams and columns. Profiled elements consist of a profile and an extrusion part. To define the profile, we have a special environment called Profile Manager. Open Gallery from the pop-up navigator or from the tab bar. Open the Profile Manager by the Options, Element Attributes, Profile Manager. By default, the project contains some predefined profiles. Click the New button to create the railing profile. Enter Gallery Railing for the name, and click OK. A profile editor window opens. Here you can define the profile with fills, but you can use any lines as well as construction geometry. The X icon indicates the baseline position of the profile. We want to create a glazed wood railing. First, we create the bottom wooden part. Activate the Fill tool in the toolbox. Select the Timber Floor Fill pattern in the info box. Select the rectangular geometry method. Zoom into the X icon in the profile editor window. Draw a rectangle starting at the X sign. Click the X and type X 0.05 and then Y 0.20 into the tracker. Press Enter. Change the fill pattern to glass in the info box. Draw another rectangle on top of the wooden one. Enter X 0.01 and Y 0.15 into the tracker and press the Enter key. Set the snap guides and points back to between nodes. Move the glass fill to the middle of the wooden fill as presented on the screen. Select the glass fill and use the Move, Drag command from the context menu. Select the two fills and select the Move, Drag a copy option from the context menu, and drag a copy upwards. Finally, select one of the wooden fills and drag a copy to the top of the glass fill as shown on the screen. Now the railing is 0.9 meters high. In the Design Layers panel of the Profile Manager, check both the horizontal stretch and vertical stretch checkboxes. Notice that additional lines appear in the Profile Editor window. These lines control what happens if you resize the height of the profiled wall. If these are on, only the part between the lines will be stretched. If turned off, the stretch height command will not be available for the profiled wall. Drag the horizontal lines to the middle of the glass part fills. This way, if you stretch the wall, the footing and the handrail parts will keep their size. Click the Store Profile button. Close both the Profile Editor and Profile Manager. Zoom into the stairs on the gallery. Activate the Wall tool in the toolbox. Open its Settings dialog and display the Geometry and Positioning panel. Select the Not Linked option for the wall top. Enter 0.00 for reference line offset. Select the Complex Profile option for structure. Select the previously created gallery railing for complex structural profile. Make sure that gallery is set as home story. Display the categories and properties panel. Select non-load-bearing element for structural function, interior for position, and railing for element classification. Select the interior partition layer. Click OK to apply all changes. Select the change geometry method in the info box. Click the corners of the gallery slab around the stairs. Double-click the last node to finish placing the railing. Zoom out and create another railing along the edge of the gallery slab, starting from the right side. Double-click the other edge to complete the railing. Let's check the result in 3D. Activate the 3D cutting plane option in the standard toolbar. The cutaway cursors appear on all four sides of the plan. Right-click on any of the scissors symbols appearing on the four sides of the floor plan window. Activate the Delete All Cutting Planes option in the context menu to remove previous instances of cutting planes. Simply drag the bottom scissors cursor upwards and release it just before the edge of the gallery slab. Open the 3D view and navigate to the slab. To show the full model content again, click the 3D cutting plane toggle on the toolbar. On floor plan views, you can use the marquee tool to define the part of the project you wish to see in 3D. Display the gallery plan. Select the marquee tool in the toolbox and select the bold marquee option in the info box. Use the bold marquee to mark an area across all stories. Right-click and choose Show Selection Marquee in 3D from the context menu. To show all elements in 3D again, right-click in the 3D window and select the Show All in 3D option from the context menu. Return to the floor plan view and press Escape to remove the marquee. You may also use the Remove Marquee option from the context menu.